This call is now being recorded.
So good morning, students. Today we are going to continue with the topic that is types of systems. In the previous lecture, we discussed about the static and the dynamic system. That is, what is the difference between a static system and a dynamic system. So if the system, the output of the system, it depends only on the present input, then it is a static system. And if it is dependent upon the past as well as the future inputs, then it is a dynamic system. Static systems, they are also known as memory systems, memoryless systems, because as the output is dependent only on the present input, so there is no need to save those samples. So that is why it's a memoryless system. Whereas the dynamic system, it is a memory system or a system with memory. Fine. So this is what we discussed in the previous class. Now I am going to start with the next classification, very important classification of systems, that is causal and non-causal systems. So now let us talk about that. So next classification is, I can say the second classification, it is causal and non-causal systems. So first of all, causal system. So if your present output, it depends only on the present. If the present output depends on what? Present input and the past input, then the system is said to be a causal system. Means if I'm taking the output yn at time n, it means up till n, whatever inputs we have received, it will depend upon those inputs, right? And a non-causal system is a system, we will discuss the examples also. So in the non-causal system, your present output, it depends on what? On the future inputs also. Means in the non-causal system, future input will also contribute to the present output. Now let me take some example. Now if I have the output is yn, so if the present output is, obviously if present we take as n only, so the present output is y of n. Now let us represent our system like this, that is, it is equal to n into xn, or it can only be xn or xn plus 2 or whatever, anything you can take. Means, and this is the present output, it is dependent only on the present input. So this is an example of a causal system. Now let us make some changes in this system only. Plus I will write x of n minus 2. So this is a past input. So it means our present output, it is dependent upon the present input as well as the past input. Even then this system is a causal system, because our present input is dependent on the present output, it is dependent on the present input and the past input. Now if I add another term in this, let us say I add, so this is an example of a causal system. Fine. Now let us add another input in this, plus x of n plus 2, or let us say x of n plus 1 or 3, whatever. So this is a future input. Fine. So now in this case, our system, that becomes a non-causal system, because our present input, it is dependent upon the past as well as the present as well as the future also. So wherever the future input comes into picture, it becomes a non-causal system. Is it clear to everyone? This is very important concept, and this question every time it comes. And this concept is going to be used throughout our signals and systems and digital signal processing. If there is any doubt, you can ask me. I will discuss more examples also. Let us do it now only. One or two simple examples. Now you will tell me that whether that system is a causal system or a non-causal system. Any doubt? Any doubt to anyone up till here?
No, ma'am.
I hope it's clear. Just hold on. Okay. Just.
मैम आपका माइक म्यूट है मैम शायद। मैम मैम का माइक म्यूट म्यूट है क्या?
Oh, sorry students, by mistake. Okay. I will repeat. Yeah. So I was taking another example, that is y of n, it is equal to x of 2n. I am taking this case. So in this case, so slowly and slowly we'll come to know, because this becomes a future input. When I am saying I am taking n is equal to 1, it is equal to n is 1, so it is equal to x of 2, right? So x of 2 means your input at n is equal to 1, your output at n is equal to 1, it is dependent upon your input at n is equal to 2. So it means this is a future input. So that is why this system is what? A non-causal system. Is it clear? Yes, students, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt to anyone, beta, please ask me, because this concept should be clear to everyone. Nobody should have a doubt in this. You will not get direct questions. So this was the first question that I discussed. This is a simple, it comes in under 1 or 2 marks only. So you get the questions for 2 marks. So let us take another system. That is yn is equal to, it is equal to x of minus n. Let us see. Now in questions like this, so what you have to do, your system should be actually satisfy all the values of n. So let us, in this case, we will take for n is equal to 0. We will also take some negative value of n. We will also take some positive value of n. So let us now take, that is for n is equal to 0. For n is equal to 0 means your y of 0 will be equal to x of minus 0 is again 0. So it means this is only the present. ठीक है? Your output at n is equal to 0, it is equal to your input at n is equal to 0. Fine? Now, for let us say n is equal to, let us say minus 1. So, y of minus 1 will be equal to x of, yes, n is minus 1, so it will be equal to x of 1. Fine? And for n is equal to 1, your y of 1, that is equal to x of minus 1. So what does this mean? It means that you cannot take only one values. In questions like this, where you have some, there's a change in the sign of the value of n, you have to check for all the values. So for here, it's okay. For here, it's okay that it's depending on the past inputs. But for n is equal to minus 1, it is dependent upon the future input. Fine. So it means that a system represented by this particular equation, that is what? A non-causal system again. I hope it's clear, both these questions. These simplest hai, matlab questions that can make the concept of the causal and non-causal system clear. You will get questions like this. You will have some other, you will have some other terms plus in this, plus something in this you can have. So, but the concept should be clear to you. You should be able to analyze the system and find out whether it's a causal or non-causal.